It's Bourbon Night. Hello, I'm Chad.
I'm Sarah.
And look, state of the world right now, people are quarantined, they're social distancing.
Mm-hmm. And don't worry, we won't say uncertain times.
We're all in this together. But, you know, we're not trying to put an importance on things that have been shut down.
Right.
But in our neck of the woods, one thing that hit us, among others...
It hits home.
...is distillery tours.
It's right, yep. On the weekends, we find ourselves itching to go out to do those distillery tours and see what's up. And, you know, you just can't do that right now.
But wait, can you?
Now you can.
That's right.
Virtually.
Now, our partners over at Buffalo Trace reached out to us and said, hey, do you know about our virtual Buffalo Trace tour? And we were like,
Do what?
So what we're going to do today is take you on a virtual tour of Buffalo Trace. We're now putting the link to it up here and also down in our show notes, our description. Mm-hmm. There's a clickable link where you can go over there.
Yep.
So we're going to take you on a virtual tour.
Let's go.
Of Buffalo Trace Distillery. What do you want to do, Sarah?
My name is Freddie Johnson.
Oh, hi, Freddie.
Let's go with the hard hat tour.
All right.
Walk past ADOC and Maxine's garden and chill room.
Wow. We've been there many a time, right? It's about 30 minutes from where we live.
But you know, when you're there, you don't look at things the same way as you're looking at them here.
Bottle,
hey, look, there's a bottle.
Bottle. No, come back.
No, good.
No, hey.
Now
no.
You blew it.
No, come back. What main ingredient is needed to make Buffalo Trace bourbon? Sarah?
It's gonna be corn chaff.
It's gonna be corn chaff. Hey, good job. They're gonna get better.
See, I never noticed.
Yes, this mural. No, Freddie. So this mural, what's really cool, when you walk by it and it's designed to be like this, it like moves.
It like follows you?
Yeah. I've been drinking before this tour. I'm a little...
Yeah, Chad's having a little trouble. There we go. Okay.
Yeah.
But you know what's crazy about this is that like I've been there 15, 20 times and I've never noticed this mural. But now that we're walking through it and like I have no... other external stimulus to distract me because I'm always like, it smells good.
Are you talking to somebody?
Right, yeah.
Now you got Freddie in your ear.
No, this is awesome.
All right, back to the guided tour.
Back to it. So you can like hit these little exclamation points, have some learning about each of the buildings, get you some education.
Yeah. 8 to 10 trucks a day will come in with our whole grains. Samples will be collected from each truck and sent to the quality control lab for tests looking for moisture content, pollutants.
Now that I do remember.
Yeah, we've seen grain drop from there.
It's literally as close to being there as you could possibly be. I feel nostalgic. Get that bottle. What year was William LaRue Weller born? Oh, that, I'm gonna go with, let's go with A.
All right.
1825. Hey, good job.
Good job.
What is kind of cool about this app is that I think that they recognize the collector nature of their audience. And we're like, it's very Pokemon. Like, I gotta catch them all.
Gotta catch them all.
But I have to.
Let's enter.
Let's enter.
What we got here?
Cookers.
Okay. Cookers.
Into the mash house. To start the mashing process,
I don't think I've been in
the
this.
Corn is added in the
pretty sure this is a hard hat only.
Yeah.
Which I've been on once.
We can take the stairs.
The mashing process takes about.
It's hard to get on the hard hat tour sometimes because it books up pretty quick, you know?
Oh, the no swimming sign. That's a real
thing.
I
love that.
Yeah.
Yes.
There's a story behind it. I think someone either tried to jump in or something.
Well, why don't you just click the little thing? Please take note of this sign. While the mash looks tempting, we must take the sign very seriously. Once fermentation really gets going, there wouldn't be enough surface tension to stay afloat. Oh my goodness.
You will drown.
You will drown, basically.
Across the catwalk to fermenters. In these tanks, the sweet mash
will undergo through there?
Transformation when it has...
So I think the cool thing about this, Sarah, is if you want to get really like geeky with it and get the nuts and bolts of how bourbon is made.
You could totally go through and click every button.
Yeah, you just click everything or you just listen to Freddie. Or if you just want to look around or like collect the bottles or do trivia, then you can just do that.
It's like kind of a choose your own adventure.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, you even get the sound effects.
Oh, yeah.
No, hey, look, there is a bottle. What is that?
I want that bottle.
This very limited 20-year-old bourbon whiskey lives up to its name. It is aged on the first floors of the warehouse to ensure a smooth finish.
Ooh, I think it's...
I'm going to have to go with B, Pappy... Oh, no! Is it Double Eagle Very Rare?
Yeah, answer is A.
Oh, that makes sense. Wow, we suck.
Okay, been here.
High wine, low wine.
High wine, low wine, the white dog off the still. Now I'm just looking for bottles.
Chad, don't be that person. He's just that person.
I want the bottles.
I want to hear what Freddie has to say. Oh, I've been up here.
What
a nice view.
That's a good
view. Especially like if I went in the morning and it was cold out and they were cooking and so there was lots of steam. It was very cinematic.
Back to the guided tour. Warehouse C.
Beautiful.
You always get to go into Warehouse C. I think that's where we're going.
Oh, it looks like
Whoa! Yeah, extreme close up. All right. What's it say? Outside Warehouse C. Yep.
1881. But I mean, they have been the longest operating distillery, over 200 years.
They continually operating distillery
and the most award winning.
Well, there you go.
Fun fact.
See, every oak barrel in these ricks is sealed.
And sometimes they just let a bottle sit on the floor.
Bomb.
No, they don't.
Made of a
Willer Antique. Nice. Now we have 7.
Blanton's Bottling Hall is where each bottle of Blanton's single barrel bourbon.
I'm gonna get that bottle.
I see it.
And bottled the contents of that barrel.
Really animated. Stag
Junior. That's what I'm drinking right now.
Here, what's he doing? But this is how I dance. I dance like this when Freddy's talking. Fred talks.
We hope you enjoyed this.
Wow!
We both say.
Nice collection you're putting
together.
Oh, I missed 2.
Wow.
I'm ashamed.
I am so disappointed.
I am ashamed right now. All right, now I think we'll do a little distillery tour.
Well, let's do a little distillery tour.
It's like we're riding a drone. No, I've actually never been.
I've never been on that part. Gardens. Yeah, me either.
Warehouse X is the most advanced whiskey warehouse ever built.
X.
For decades, we have been crafting experimental whiskeys by exploring variables such as unique mash bills, barrel char levels, and different types of wood.
That is crazy.
And another bottle.
Another bottle.
12-year.
What is the name for the bourbon that is evaporated during the aging process? That's going to be Angel Share, Chad.
But I like bourbon breath.
Lock it in.
All right, lock it in. Okay, good job.
Through the grass, straight down the hill to the old Taylor House.
We've been there too.
In the 1800s, a second story was added as the distillery developed around it. Throughout the years, it has served as a laboratory and infirmary for the distillery.
Oh, William LaRue Weller. Don't mind if I do. Bottle siding.
Experimental.
Currently, there are more than 5,000 experimental barrels of whiskey aging in its warehouse. I thought it was like 10, but I guess this is more up to date.
Yeah.
Then into OFC Distillery. Now come take another step back into bourbon history. This building, long used for storage.
Now, this is a tour we have not been on. This is the first time I'm seeing this.
Constructed in 1882, as well as pieces of the two earlier versions.
Oh, I have goosebumps.
Bottle. Got it.
That's. Oh, the OFC lives down there.
OFC vintage.
I can't tell from that far away if this is an ancient age or a Pappy.
I'm going to say Pappy. Let's click on it.
Yep. Hey!
Ripton!
Welcome to our bitters facility.
Bottle!
Hey, there's a bitters facility?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. I learned something today.
Well, hey, that concludes the distillery tour. That was an awesome tour. And it doesn't take as long as it normally does. Because instead of walking, you're like, zoom!
You get to fly like a drone.
You get to fly on a drone.
Yeah, from your couch.
Okay, see how we did.
Nice collection you're putting together here.
Missed two.
No, one. Two. Dad got it!
All right, let's do the barrel tour.
All right.
Go to an inside branding shed.
Whatever you say, Freddy.
This is the first stop.
Yeah,
I'm
literally, you're in
charge. Golf carts are always there.
And they, whoever uses them.
They are brought into the shed.
Sorry to cut you off, Freddy. I was eager to get in that building. Well,
don't
even try to hide it.
What is the name of Buffalo Trace mascot at Buffalo Trace Distillery? It's B, Thunder.
It's Thunder.
I know, because I have him. But does Buffalo love you? Our dog also loves his buffalo. She can't have it, though. I've never been in here before.
Look at all them barrels.
Look at that. They're beautiful. I haven't seen them in so long. Do you think they're doing okay?
I think they're doing just fine.
Do you think they're sleeping
they're
okay?
They're aging, yes. Yes. Yeah.
White Dog comes from the still house here to the cistern room.
The campus is big.
Yeah.
I don't know. I guess I just didn't realize how much was there. It's and what each of these buildings is when you walk by them on one tour. Whereas like this, I'm just amazed. I've been there so many times, I've never thought about these places.
This building was the original regauge area.
What is this?
It's the regauge facility.
I've never been in here either.
Oh, I just hit a...
Oh.
Oh, I just
stop hitting yourself.
Pass.
Stop hitting yourself.
I just hit a post.
I've never noticed that either.
The firehouse?
Yes. You guys, I'm really unobservant when it comes to real life. But you got to put it on a phone and I'll be like, hey, there's a detail.
Warehouse H is the...
Oh, Warehouse H. You're drinking something from Warehouse H.
I am. I'm actually drinking Blantons from Japan.
Metal-sided warehouses enjoy bigger temperature fluctuations, which can help bourbon reach maturity faster. Every barrel of Blanton's bourbon is aged in this warehouse.
This is where the smell of the distillery,
and that is,
like when you come in, it's just like, oh.
I wish we had smell-o-vision here.
Yes.
Can I put headphones in my nose?
Yeah, I mean, you can try. I'd like
can I get
to see
the smell?
That.
We're going in the clubhouse.
Going in the clubhouse.
What a big bottle of Elmer T. Lee.
Son, we're not hiring any hands today, were the words that greeted this man when he first showed up to interview at the George T. Stagg Distillery in 1949. That's gotta be Elmer T. Lee. Okay.
Let's look at our bottles. Let's see what we got.
Nice collection you're putting together here.
We did. Every time we missed two bottles.
How do we miss them? Or we're gonna have to do it again.
Let's meet our tour guy. Let's meet Freddy.
Let's meet Freddy.
There he is.
Well, we've met Freddy.
Oh, yeah, we've met Freddy.
I mean, what a just a genuine human.
Okay, well, Sarah, we just took three virtual tours, headphones out.
We did.
At Buffalo Trace.
We collected
here
a
at the
hell
comfort
of a lot of bottles.
Of our table and comfort of our glasses.
It's true.
That's really cool. That is, as we've said before, as close as you can get to the real thing
right
now. And, you know, we've gotten emails from people saying, I had to cancel my trip to Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
Not going to be able to go on the tour. Well, here is the next best thing.
I learned things today on that. Just being able to go step by step and ingest it. In a controlled environment where I'm not distracted by smells and sights and sounds. But you know what I think the coolest thing is that while they were able to put this out right now, knowing that people are, you know, stuck at home for good reason and wanting to get back to the distilleries, that they are able to provide this to us. On the flip side, they're doing so much good with, like, the hand sanitizer efforts that they're doing.
Right.
They're providing it to, like, really big companies. Mm. And then they're doing... I think hand sanitizer sales at the distillery, which you can do through curbside pickup.
Curbside pickup, yep. In a big 175. I checked it out.
That's a lot of hand sanitizer.
Yeah. So we would definitely recommend you take this virtual tour, even if you've been there, because we've been there, as we said, many times.
Let's throw up the link again.
Learn new things. Let's do it. Link is up here. Clickable link down in the description. We also want to tell you guys about WhiskeyAmbitions.com. It's our home on the internet. Hey, look, we're both wearing t-shirts from Whiskey Ambitions. You can get t-shirts. You can get glassware now back in stock. You can get challenge coins and always more coming soon at WhiskeyAmbitions.com.
You can become a patron at patreon.com/itsbourbonnight. You get inside scoops on great opportunities, patron-only podcasts, and more coming all the time.
That's right. Hey, if you haven't subscribed to us already, we would love it if you did. You can click right up here to do so if you want. There are suggestions of other videos you can check out. We hope to see you over there in those. Thanks, Sarah.
Thank you, Chad.
Okay, until next time, drink more bourbon.